this thread, the effective diameter for this thread. Now, for that what I need? These are the metric threads. Metric thread means what? Angle included between two flanks are 60 degree. Correct? These are the threads. With the, this is what? Distance between two troughs is minor diameter. Distance between two crests is major diameter. Major dia, this is called as minor dia. This is called as thread depth. This is called as thread depth. Now I want to find out the effective diameter. Effective diameter means what? Pitch circle diameter, pitch diameter. It is called as pitch diameter. You can find out this pitch diameter once you deduct major diameter. The effective diameter you can find out. Major diameter minus thread depth. Okay. Now, what I'll do? I'll insert the wire. Two wire method we are going to find out. I'll insert the wire of same diameter. Okay. Insert the wire of same diameter. Now, this is the what? Pitch diameter. This is the pitch diameter of this thread, and this reading is what? This is the reading. This is called as dimension measured under the wire. This is known as T. This is known as T. This reading is known as pitch value. Pitch value by 2. This distance between the T and the pitch circle diameter. This is known as P dash by 2. Now this is also same way, P dash by 2. Now if I want to find out E, can I write E is equal to T plus P dash by 2 of this P dash by 2? This is E, no? This is E. I am interested to find out this E. This E. Now this E is what? T plus P dash by 2 plus P dash by 2. So P dash by 2 plus P dash by 2 is equal to T plus P dash. So E is equal to effective diameter is equal to, this is equation 1. I am going to find out this E. Now this, first consider this P dash. How to find out the P dash? P dash is nothing but the pitch value. Pitch value of thread. Now pitch value of thread, P dash is equal to, for metric thread. This is metric thread. Why it is metric thread? M is written over here. This is M. M is written. So we are interested to find out the value of this. So for metric thread, pitch value is 0.866 into pitch. This is pitch minus D. D is the wire diameter. Now here we will consider DB is the best wire size diameter. Now first, DB is equal to best wire size diameter is equal to, best wire size diameter is equal to 0.866 into pitch is what? 2. 0.866 into 2 minus, sorry, this DB is not 0.6, DB is equal to P by 2 into sec theta by 2. Pitch is what? 2 by 2. Sec theta is what? 60 degree. So sec 30. So DB is equal to sec 30. So can I write 1 by cos 30? Sec 30. So find out the value of cos 30. Take the reciprocal of that and you will get the value of DB, best wire size diameter. 1.1547 mm is the best wire size diameter. Okay. Now this best wire size diameter I am going to put in this value. 0.866 into 2 is the pitch. This is the formula I am going to use. Minus 1.1547. So pitch value is what? 0.578 mm. Now I know the P dash value, but I don't know this T. Now I can find out this T is equal to D plus or minus R2 minus R1. Okay. Now D is what? D is master cylinder diameter. What is R2? R2 is reading over threaded plug gauge. This is threaded plug gauge. R2 is reading over threaded plug gauge by using wire. I'm going to insert the wire and I'll take the reading over threaded plug gauge. R1 is reading over master cylinder. Okay, then I'll find out the value of R2 and R1. Okay, now let us start with the experiment. These are the two centers. This is floating carriage micrometer. We are going to insert the job between the two centers of floating carriage micrometer. Ensure that these two centers are perfectly clamped. Now what I am going to do? I am going to adjust the zero. You can see I am going to adjust. See this zero here, you can see this zero is adjusted with this zero. I am going to take two wires of equal diameter. I am going to insert these two wires. Somebody will help me to this is one wire. Okay, and this is second wire. Okay. Let it be fine. So this is here we are going to apply the threads to hold this wire fixed. We are going to apply small pressure on this wire. Okay, so we are not going to apply so much pressure on this wire, and now we are going to take reading with the help of wire. See these two wires. Now how many divisions it has crossed? Two divisions on the thimble. You can see that this there is a barrel. If you see the floating carriage micrometer, what it has, it you just see. I'll take the reading first and then I'll let you know how to take. There are two divisions. One division on barrel corresponds to how many mm? See, there are five. If this is 5 mm, 5 mm corresponds to 10 divisions. 5 mm corresponds to 10 division. So 1 division correspond is what? 0.5 mm. So 0.5 mm, 1 division on this barrel is 0.5 mm. So it has crossed how many divisions? 2 divisions. You can see that this is symbol 1 and 2. Mm. 2 divisions. So 1 division is 0.5 into 2 division plus. Now I want to find out the least count of vernier scale 1. How to find out least count of vernier scale 1? How many divisions are there on this vernier scale? It starts from 0 and ends with 0. 0.49. It ends with 0.5 here. Starts with 0 and ends with 0.5. So 0, see here carefully. 0 to 0.1. How many divisions are there? 5 divisions are there. Likewise, 0.02, 0.03, 0.04, 5 up to 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9 and 0.1. 5. How many divisions are there?
50
divisions. So 0 to 0.1 are 50 divisions. Likewise, 0 to 0.5 divisions, how many there are?
250
divisions. On this is referred as vernier scale 1. Yeah. On vernier scale 1, there are 250 divisions. Now, one division on barrel is 0.5. So, we are interested to find out least count of this. So, 0.5 divided by 250. Least count of vernier scale 1 is 0.002 mm. Can I say least count of this vernier scale? So how I am going to take reading here again? It has cross 2 division on barrel plus 0.002 is the least count of vernier scale 1. Number of division on vernier scale 1 is matching with a 0. Which division it is matching? 0.46. 0.465 into 5. 230, can I say? 230. But whether it is matching 46, no. 231 and 231 it is matching now. If you see carefully. 0.46 ke baad ki kaun si division match ho rahi? Second division match ho rahi. Second division match ho rahi. So 0.46 means how many division? 230. Plus 2 division matlab 232 divisions are matching. So 0.02 into 232 divisions. 232 division on vernier scale is matching with this 0. This 0 is here. This 0 is matching with 232 division. If you see carefully. Now plus least count of vernier scale 2. Now where that vernier scale 2 is? This is vernier scale 2. If you see 0 to 20, it has marking, but it has only 10 divisions. How they have reduced the list count? See, consider 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 divisions. These are the 10 division on vernier scale 1. Okay. These 10 division on vernier scale 1 are matching with, we will see how it match. This is vernier scale 2. The 10 division on vernier scale 2 are matching with 10 division on vernier scale 2 are matching with 9 division on vernier scale 1. 10 division on vernier scale 2, this is vernier scale 2. Okay, this 10 division are matching with 9 division on vernier scale 1. Now you know 1 division on vernier scale 1 is how many, how much? We just calculated this 0.002. So 9 division, can I write 9 division on VS1 is matching with 10 division on VS2. So I am interested to find out 1 division on VS1. Now how I am going to find out? 9 division, 1 division corresponds to 0.002. So 9 division corresponds to, can I write here 0.018 mm? So 0.018 mm is equal to 10 division. So 1 division, am I right?
1 upon 0.001.
This is vernier scale 2. Vernier scale 2, 9 division on vernier scale 1 corresponds to 10 division on vernier scale 2. So 1 division on vernier scale 2 corresponds to how many divisions? I am interested to find out this. Now I know that 9 division on vernier scale corresponds to 0.018 mm. So I am interested to find out 1 by 10 into 0.018. So 0.018 mm, 1 division on vernier scale 2. 1 division on vernier scale 2 is 0.0018 mm, and 1 division on vernier scale 1 is 0.002 mm. Now I have used in combination of these two scales. So what I'm what I'll do, I'll subtract VS1 and I'll do the subtraction of VS1 and VS2. So what is 0.0018, correct?
Yes.
So what I have got, 0.002 mm. So least count we have reduced using vernier scale. Have you understood this?
Yes, sir.
0.002 mm. This is a 0.002 mm.
Sir,
now,
so
0.002 mm. Now I'll tell you. Once this experience is recording. Now this is 0.002 mm. Now what I'll do? I'm going to take the reading on vernier scale 2. Which division, which number of division of vernier scale 2 is matching with this vernier scale 1? See, now what I am going to do, what I am going to do, which number of division on vernier scale 2 is matching with vernier scale 1. Suppose this division, which division is, this is first, this is second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. So this seventh division on vernier scale 2 is matching with vernier scale 1. Here we will see which number of division is matching. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is not matching, 6 is matching, am I right? 6 is matching. So what I will do, I know the least count 0.002 into 6. I know the least count 0.002 into 6. Now calculate this value, this is called as R1. This is called as R1. So value we got, whatever the value, we will write over here. Then what we are going to do, we are going to replace this master cylinder by using threaded plug gauge. Without disturbing this, what I am going to do is going to remove this master cylinder from here. I am going to insert without touching this, okay? Without touching this, what I am going to do, I am going to introduce again the same way. Inserting the wire.
That's a rule good.
Inserting the wire. You can feel. Okay. Now see. This is, I have not disturbed. Now I am going to take reading over threaded plug gauge by inserting wire. Value I got 1.4652 mm R1. Now what is value of R2? R2 is reading over threaded plug gauge, no? Reading over threaded plug gauge. I have inserted threaded plug gauge, I have inserted wire. Now I am going to take the reading. Which division? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 division into 0.5 plus you know the least count 0.002. Number of division matching is 6. 6 division is matching. You can see 0.561 is matching. Am I right? 61 is matching plus 6, no? 0 to 0.01 is 5 division. Above that is 5 plus 1, 6 division is matching. You know the least count into 6 number of division on vernier scale. Now what you are going to do? You know the least count of 0.002 mm on vernier scale 2. This is least count of vernier scale 1. Now this is least count of vernier scale 2. Now you are going to find out the which number of division on vernier scale is matching. Vernier scale 2, just see. 1 is not matching. 2nd is not matching. Last one is matching. No, it is not matching perfectly. If you see that, 10th division is matching. So 10th division, so 4, 5s are 2, 20.
2.01.
So this value we have got 2.104 mm R2. Now we got R1, we got R2. Now we are going to place this value in this equation. Where is that equation? Here we know the diameter is 16.0025 mm. Now here we have to take what value we have got answer of R2 is 2.014, which is greater than R1. So we will subtract 1.4652. We know that. Now this answer is greater. R2 is greater than R1, so this will come positive answer. So we will consider this positive because master cylinder is smaller than the major diameter of the thread. So what value we have got?
16.5513.
This is value of T. 16.5513. Now we know that E is equal to T plus P dash. Now we have got 16.5513
plus P dash. P dash is what? 0.578. So E is equal to
17.1293 mm.
What value we have got? This is the value of effective diameter of this screw thread. Understood? Cut.